top of the 7 o'clock hour. It's Bob Smalls here on KGRI, bringing you the best in news, weather, and intramural sports, serving the single county area with 500 watts of blistering broadcasting power. Now let's check traffic.
Thanks, Bob. Oh, there's a car. There's one. Bob.
Now here's today's pop quiz brought to you by the Taco Freeze. Manager Tickle Nurgen says, hello, how are you? I am fine, thank you. Here we go. I bet no one knows this one. What is the one single animal that is monogamous even after its mate's death?
It's the swan.
Time's up, folks. Nice try. It's the swan.
The ink is black, the page is white. Together we learn to read and write. A child is black, a child is white. The whole world looks upon a sight, a beautiful sight.
The world is black, the world is white. It turns by day and then by night. The child is black, the child is white. The whole world looks upon a sight, a beautiful sight.
Simmer class, simmer. Today we'll begin our discussion of Shakespeare's Romeo and Juliet. Now who knows what happens to them?
They die.
Well, yes, but why? Theodore?
Mononucleosis?
No, they don't die from mononucleosis.
Gym shorts!
Mrs. Munger, Phoebe said gym shorts.
Simmer.
Excuse me, Mrs. Munger, I seem to be the only one with my hand raised.
Yes, Dawn?
Romeo and Juliet is the story of two young lovers who defy their feuding families in order to be together.
Then they die.
Cut it out!
Mrs. Munger, the twins are tormenting Grace with Shakespearean taunting.
We're not twins.
Beside it, she doth buggest us in the largest manner.
Wench!
Cut it out!
Simmer, simmer, simmer. Well, Mr. Nort, welcome.
Hello, class. Please, sit.
We are sitting!
Well done.
What brings you here?
Oh, well, I must be in the wrong classroom.
Well, actually, Mr. Nort, you're in the wrong school.
Yes, well, Central is closed today. I'll wait outside.
The lights are on, but nobody's home.
Thank you, Neighborhood Watch.
I drew a picture of Mr. Nort.
But his head's all crooked.
Well, that's why I drew it that way.
Okay, how about Juliet?
We saw a movie called Juliet's Mojo.
Excuse me, but I believe that's unlikely. That movie received an R rating from the Motion Picture Association of America.
Mrs. Munger, the twins said they went to an R movie.
We're not twins!
If you saw it, then what's it about?
If you're so smart, you tell me.
I didn't say I saw it.
What's it about?
Yeah, tell us!
Simmer, simmer, simmer!
Hey!
Now, George, and George, if a film is rated R, it may contain scenes of excessive violence and or exposure of the human,
Mojos?
Simmer. Now, quickly, who knows the names of Romeo and Juliet's families, Mahoot?
What?
The names?
What?
Of the families?
What?
The names?
What?
Of the...
Elephant.
Oh, for God's sake.
Mrs. Munger is like a bug in a Mr. Nort Venus flytrap.
What are you guys talking about, Munger?
Mrs. Munger needs a man like Jane Goodall needs another monkey.
You mean gorilla.
I mean hairy and unnecessary.
Are you saying Mrs. Munger and Mr. Nort? No way! Nuh-uh!
Yuh-huh!
He's closing in like a Venus fly trap.
Hey! You guys! I'm stuck in my locker, you guys!
Mrs. Munger, first, let me say that your hair looks particularly tall today.
Why, thank you. I like your blazer.
You know, we've been neighbors for a while, and, well, sometimes a man's gotta pull himself up by the things and crawl on his knees to the glass, and damn it, woman, I just gotta ask, will you go to dinner with me at the Mandarin Choo-Choo?
The Chinese place in the old train car?
Hence the name, Choo Choo.
Yes!
Oh, good! I'll drive over around 7.
But, Nort, you live next door.
Oh.
No. Drive is fine.
Good. Choo Choo.
I know you did not see that movie.
We did too. You're just too young to hear about it.
Then why don't you tell Brad? He's old enough.
Hey, Brad. How come you're 17 and you're still in junior high?
Hey, I'm just trying to get it right, all right? I mean, you don't get to be assistant manager at a taco freeze by sitting around on your dirt bike.
Actually, I think that's exactly how you do it.
Hey, you want to ride home or not?
These guys said they saw Julius Mojo.
Haha, good movie, right? Like there's a scene in it, right? Where she's scared and hiding out, right? And she's gonna run away, alright? But first, she takes a shower.
A shower?
A shower.
Whoa.
Mrs. Munger?
Mr. Swain?
I'll be glad to let you go on your way, but first, what can I take back in my gunny sack? Do you have any information?
The sky is blue, the sun is out, I'm wearing pantyhose.
Enough! Today at our school, I saw Mr. Nort. You know, he teaches at Central, our arch rival.
It's a school, Mr. Swain, not a warring nation.
That's not exactly true, Mrs. Munger. Central, more than rival. 32 years ago, a scrappy lad named Swain was a student at Central.
Mr. Swain, for Jiminy Christmas cake, not that again. You can't base your whole life on one missed field goal.
I made the field goal. I was facing the wrong way. Harrison never stopped making fun of me.
You know how cruel children can be.
He was the principal. You just don't get over that.
I guess not. You had a film strip made about it.
Just let it be known that fraternization with Central is completely against my better judgment. And consider this. I have a brand new opaque projector that is supposed to go to your classroom.
One of the big gray ones?
Big and gray and opaque. I have my eyes on you.
That must hurt.
Yo, Tickle.
Yeah?
There's a package for you.
Are you sure it's for me?
Tickle Nurgin. Yeah? Name's right here in black and white.
It must be my copier repairman uniform. Oh, yes. No, whoa. Back on your side. No, back this way. Back this way.
Little more. Hey, bro.
Okay. You'll get used to it.
I'm just saying that we have to go see Juliet's Mojo now. But it's rated R, so we wear disguises that make us look older. How old do you have to be to see an R movie? I don't know. 18? 17? I'm gonna wear these fake mutton chop sideburns and my brother's square-toed dingo boots. What do you got? I'm gonna wear these really big headphones. Boss. Stud. Awesome. Rad. Cool. Rad.
Who's this picture of? Your father?
No, that's my late husband. I'm a widow.
I'm sorry. I don't...
Oh, it's all right. It's not like you killed him. Or did you? Okay, just a joke.
Oh, good.
He died in his sleep.
Oh, ouch.
Anyway, you never really get over it, but you get used to it.
Well, I don't mean any disrespect. Honestly, woman, I feel a little awkward going out with you. If I put myself in his place...
You'd be inside a little brass urn and smelling like old books. But you're not. You're alive. Get over it.
Still, I hope he doesn't mind.
One, please.
You know this is an R movie.
Yeah, and I'm 17.
What year were you born?
1817? Hey, are you saying that I'm old enough to get drafted and go to war for our country, but I can't even go to a movie?
Here, $7. But if it turns out you're lying, you're in big trouble. Oh, hello, sir.
One, please.
I thought the guy in front of you was trying to sneak in.
Damn kids.
Closed for New Year? That's ridiculous. It's the middle of February.
Oh, tootin' to booties, North. The Chinese New Year.
Oh, good.
Hands on wheel.
Yes, yes. Say, why don't we go see a movie instead? We could see that action picture Juliet's Mojo. Although I hear the language is a little frank.
Well, I always liked a good Sinatra picture.
Good, good. Good, good. Good, good. No!
Subject heading south on, south on.
See if you can follow them!
Dear, can't we go home? I'm missing Stone Phillips.
Drive!
Saved me. I'm saved. Thank you.
You're welcome, little missy. Now you can help me build my spaceship to Toledo.
Hey, a cupcake.
Oh. Hi, Tickle. Hey, if you're here, then who's at the taco freeze?
Don't worry. I trained Brad really good. He's got it cobbled.
Crap.
I'm a little scared. I need to hide out here. Then we need to run away. Keep an eye on the street.
Right.
I'm gonna take a quick shower. Ooh. Ah.
What nice tile she has in her bathroom.
George! George! Is that Mrs. Munger over there?
Where?
Oh, my. It is, it is. Ew! Teacher in public! Who is she with?
I don't know.
Oh, good. Mr. North,
you teacher in public.
Would you twins keep it down?
We're not twins.
What?
We're not twins.
Did you hear that?
What?
I thought I heard something very familiar.
Let's get out of here before we get caught.
North, my women's intuition is ringing like a fire bell. I think we should leave.
That's a bad cut. Take off those pants.
But we may see some moja.
Oh, criminy, North. That's not a real word.
Oh, my gosh. We're dead meat. Bogey at 12 o'clock.
Excuse us, gentlemen.
What happened?
Our disguises. They really worked. You know what this means? Bars.
Vegas. John Bradshaw seminars.
How about detention?
Mr. Swain! Another teacher in public. Don't you people have homes?
I want to see you twins in my office at 8 a.m. sharp.
We're not...
Oh, can it.
Zimmer class! Zimmer! This is a classroom, not a hollering contest.
Zooey ole!
Zimmer, let's get back to Romeo and Juliet. Why didn't they listen to reason? Why did they get into so much trouble?
I drew a picture of Romeo on his turbo jet ski equipped with armor-piercing missiles.
That's very nice, Artie, but I think Romeo rode a horse.
Side saddle!
Simmer, Phoebe.
Love. Love made me do it.
Mrs. Munger, Amanda's singing a love song.
Well, that's fitting. Let me ask you this. Why are there so many love songs?
Mononucleosis?
No. There are so many love songs because this magical, mystical thing called love is bigger than all of us. Even bigger than Romeo and Juliet.
Not bigger than Grace. Olay.
Where is Grace? Mahout?
What?
Do you know where Grace is?
What?
Where Grace is?
What?
Where is Grace?
Jacob Irishman. His name is Barney.
I'll be glad to let you go on your way. But first, what can I take back in my gunny sack? Do you have any information? Here's the topic. Mrs. Munger and Mr. North. I see. I'll give you 24 hours. And then, D-Day.
D-Day? For real? You're gonna wipe out the Germans? You got a time machine?
It's an expression. What do you know about a time machine?
What is gunny sack anyway? I think it's some kind of Korean food.
Nort, what brings your cheery self over?
I'm sensing trouble, woman.
Do you need to refer to me as woman?
Isn't broad out of fashion?
A tad.
I think they know about us.
What about us?
Talking, dating, riding in a car on a public road. We don't want them to find out. Our schools, they're arch rivals.
Oh, shooting stars, it's just not right. We're people. And besides, I really want that opaque projector.
Oh, boy. Oh, boy. Oh, boy. Oh, boy.
Nort. Simmer.
Okay.
I guess it's just not a good time for us to see each other. They just don't want it. I'm sorry.
Okay. Enid, I had a nice time.
Me too. And my name is Gertrude.
Oh my god! It's true! Munger and Nort! Ew! Hey, wait! Hey! Come back! Hey, let me out! Hey! Oh, Mr. Swain, thank you! Thank you for setting me free! All I had was one cupcake!
I'll be glad to let you go on your way, but first, what can I take back in my gunny sack? Do you have any information?
Yes!
Welcome to Taco Freeze, yo.
Give me a taco and an ice cream cone.
We just have hamburgers.
Okay. We were at the movies, and we saw Mrs. Munger and Mr. Nort on a date.
Ew!
And now Mr. Swain wants us to rat on them.
My uncle was once mistaken for a guy who ratted on the mob, and these thugs came and duct-taped him to a chimney. He lived, but there's a stripe on his face where hair won't grow.
He can't make you tell.
Yeah. What is it the Munger's always saying?
Zibber?
No, all that stuff about free will and freedom of choice.
I think it's Captain Kirk that says that.
Yeah! I'm not telling. Me neither.
Hey, what movie did you go see?
Oh, Juliet's Mojo. Again. Oh, yeah. Again. Because there was some subtle nuances we missed the first time around.
Okay, you guys. Last chance before class starts. Tell us about the movie. Olé.
Tell.
Tell.
Okay. Hello.
Quiet, Theo. We're hearing about Juliet.
So, Juliet is scared. And she's hiding out and planning to run away. But first, she takes a shower.
A shower?
Zimmer class! Zimmer, let's bring the boats to dock and tie them off. Now, back to Romeo and Juliet.
I drew a picture of Romeo and Juliet in love on his and her mini bikes.
Well, who are those angry people at the bottom?
Oh, those are the tiny men who want to bust them around because they want to.
Very nice. Although, I don't think Romeo and Juliet had mini bikes.
Mrs. Munger!
Yes, Mr. Swain?
There's something I want you to say goodbye to.
My opaque projector!
No buts, Mrs. Munger.
I didn't say but.
But!
Mrs. Munger! Phoebe said...
Got it, sissy. Chill.
You have engaged in a relationship that is against my better judgment. What can you say to that?
What can I say? Well, frankly, Mr. Swain, at the risk of losing a truly wonderful piece of projection technology, your better judgment could use some bona fide improvement. Because if you think you're going to tell me who I can and cannot see outside of this classroom, you are quite off your rocker-doodle-doo. What about free will? And what about freedom of choice?
She does say that.
I just have to say that you, Mr. Swain, you can... see!
Mr. Swain, your shoe's untied.
That's not funny!
Way to go, Ms. Munger. Olay! Munger! Munger!
Munger! Munger! Munger! Munger! Munger!
Munger! Munger! Okay, simmer. Thank you. Whew! I'm all pumped up. Don, grab that opaque projector, bring it over here, and chain it to my desk. Pronto!
Gladly, Your Highness. Mrs. Munger.
Now, let's get back to Romeo and Juliet. When things get tough, oh, I'm still pumped up! Romeo plans to meet Juliet. What does Juliet do, Theodore?
She's scared, and she's hiding out, and she's planning to run away.
Very good.
And then she takes a shower.
A shower?
A shower.
Oh, boy. I think I need a pound cake. Nort, I was being a little foolish. We don't need to hide. I think you're considerate and kind, and in some ways you even remind me of my late husband.
You mean I smell like old books?
No. Although, I do like that smell. I mean, I would like to go out with you again.
Oh, good God!
Oh, Lordy!
I'm okay.
Crud.
I can see clearly now, the rain is gone. See all obstacles in my way. Gone are the dark clouds that had me blind. It's gonna be a bright, sunshiny day. It's gonna be a bright.